Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Pirelli Veterans Arena in Franklin, Massachusetts. Tom Nappy alongside Mike Tarosian to bring you Hopkinton Hillers boys varsity playoff hockey. And this afternoon, it is the quarterfinals round of the South Division III bracket, and they will welcome in Old Rochester. Pirelli Veterans Arena is the home arena for the Hillers during the playoffs due to the fact that it has a little bit more capacity here, and there is a whole lot of fans that are here to watch their Hopkinton Hillers in playoff action. And today, those fans are sporting some red, white, and blue. They're going with the American theme, hoping that perhaps it'll maybe distract Old Rochester a little bit, but the fans already packing the stands, and it is an absolutely great atmosphere here today.
I tell you, you got the noise from both sides here. We have the Old Rochester right to the right of us, and of course our Hiller faithful across from us, and I can't tell who's louder. I mean, they're further away, they're just as loud as the guys next to us. But the look, the red, white, and blue look, I don't know what it is. They got their green towels with them, I see. So that's a positive sign. Something very unusual, which hopefully we can find out in between periods, why they chose those colors. Because normally we're used to the whiteout. They were whiteout last night for the girls' game against Medway. They were whiteout here for Wednesday's game. So I don't know, something different? A lot of people don't like change. They like to keep things the same, but leave it to the Hillers. They come up with something new.
Well, maybe it's to throw Old Rochester off. Who knows? Old Rochester Fairhaven is the fifth seed, and they are 20-3 overall. They defeated Foxborough in the first round, 9-0 in dominant fashion. The Hopkinton Hillers also dominated in their first round of playoff action as they defeated Silver Lake 9-1. Hopkinton is the fourth seed with 18 wins, 2 losses, and a tie. This is the second playoff game for the Hillers. They had a bye in the preliminaries based on the fact that they had just such a great season. The winner of this game will advance to the Gallo Arena in Bourne, and they will play on Wednesday, March 8th at 5:30 p.m. against the winner of the Dartmouth Hull Middleborough game. That game is in progress right now over in Brockton. And you can hear the fans, an absolutely great atmosphere here today. They are pumped for this one. And this is going to be a tough game between two very good teams. Right now, we'll let you get a listen to those fans as we go to the national anthem.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna put the shotgun mic on for this one. I think our mics will cover the feeling in this at this arena right now.
I think so.
Persevered through the leadership and sacrifices of men and women.
Absolutely electric in here, as you can hear right now. The fans going crazy, singing along with the national anthem, and they are pumped for this one. It is going to be a fun afternoon here in Franklin. Let's talk a little bit about this old Rochester team. They have faced some very good competition throughout this season, including a familiar opponent in Westwood. Old Rochester closed out their season against Westwood with a 4-1 victory. And if you could beat Westwood 4-1, that's right there shows you're a great
huge.
Team.
That is very huge.
So this old Rochester team, they have been battle tested on multiple occasions. Besides the Westwood game, they've faced some great opponents in the Cape area. They face Shrewsbury, who's a Division I school. They lost that game, but they have plenty of experience to show for it. And we'll go over the starters for the Hopkinton Hillers in just a moment, but we are ready for faceoff in the center circle. It is Owen Delaney for the Hopkinton Hillers and Tabor Labonte, the junior for Old Rochester. Here we go. We are underway in this quarterfinals round, and the Hillers are going to put it around the boards to start things off. In the left circle, a backhander, and that one is wide to the right by Simos. Old Rochester coming up the boards. Hillers taking it back down, and we'll see what team is able to establish control early on. Let's take a look at the Old Rochester starters. It is Noah Strawn. He's a senior forward, as a hard check into the boards on the near side. He's wearing number 4. Number 9, Evan Stanley, a junior forward, as that shot is going to be a glove save by Dylan O'Leary. Sam Henry from the left circle on the wrister. And Sam Henry wearing number 10. He's a forward and a captain. Number 11, Tabor Labonte, a junior forward, wearing number 11. And number 20, Landon Gogwin, a senior defenseman, and rounding out the starting lineup for Old Rochester is the goaltender, Chase Cunningham, wearing number 40, the senior goalkeeper. And we'll get you the Hopkinton Hillers starting rotation as Old Rochester tries to clear their own zone. It is Dylan O'Leary in net for the Hillers. He started in the last playoff game and was absolutely brilliant in the victory over a gritty Silver Lake team. That one is going to be hit to the left of the net from the near side. Will Abbott is a junior forward wearing number 22. Owen Delaney, a junior forward wearing number 21. Connor Delaney, his brother, a junior defenseman. Steve Simos, a sophomore forward. And Everett Rolfe, a senior defenseman. And that rounds out the starting rotation as the Hillers in control behind their own net. Pickens coming up the near side. Up the boards he goes. Back into Old Rochester territory. We'll have an icing there. Hillers going to change up their line. Just underway here at Pirelli Veterans Arena. 13:30 left to go in the first period. A faceoff in the Hillers zone. Robert Ramsey on it for Old Rochester against Matt Lindquist. Back now behind the net, it's Coveney. Up the boards over to Horgan. Coveney coming across into the neutral zone, up the near side, puts the puck down in Old Rochester territory, up the near side board. Back and forth battles we have going early on as that one is out of play off the stick of Ben Austin. And you gotta be thankful for a situation like that. There's a net there, that one went flying.
Yeah, that was definitely heading towards the fans, and I don't think they're watching the puck that much.
We'll have a face-off now in the neutral zone. Jacob Demerinville up against Owen Delaney. Well, Hillers in control up the near side. Coveney back into Hillers territory, leaving it out in the left circle. What a check in the circle. Great defensive play by Coveney. That could have been a dangerous situation. Sam Henry nearly had the wide open shot, and now a great defensive play by Simos. Catching up behind the net with it is Labonte. Up the near side boards, the Bulldogs of Old Rochester slash Fairhaven trying to take control of this puck early on. But now they'll have to defend their zone as coming down for the Hillers is Abbott up the boards. Puck jammed in the corner, taken by Labonte. A pass over to the far side, over to the right circle goes Strawn, and he lost his possession of the puck there. Was going a little bit faster than he would have liked it. A good defensive play as well by Delaney. But now, top of the left circle, that shot deflected by Abbott. And then in front of the net, we're gonna get a whistle. It was Landon Goglin, the senior, on that shot. We'll have line changes for both teams and a faceoff in the Hiller zone. And the net got a little bit dislodged there. And that's the reason for the faceoff. Around the net. Up over to the right circle. Hard check in the boards there. Well, Rochester showing that they can play physical too. In the left circle, the backhander in front of the net. And it is defended well by J.H. Vokey. There's Landon Goglin once again looking for a shot there. The Hillers coming up in Old Rochester zone, and look at this contact. That was Ryan Labonte, senior captain, up against Hunter Temple. We get a whistle. Will there be a penalty? That was a hard hit. Let's see what the officials say. Nothing yet. No penalty. Mike, some brutal hits in this one so far.
I tell you, very physical game, and the referees are letting them play.
That's what you have to do in these playoff games. You got two heavyweights going at it in this one. It is fourth-seeded Hopkinton, fifth-seeded Old Rochester. No one knows how this game's going to go. Of course, the large amount of Hillers fans that showed up are hoping that Hopkinton will be at the Cape next week. Is that one off the left pad of the goaltender? Into the backboards it goes. Hillers in control, coming around, it's Lindquist. A pass up to the blue line to Pickens, slap shot there, defended well. Now on the corner, trying to lodge it in from the side, and it was knocked out by the defender, Evan Stanley, and then it went off the pad of Cunningham. Hillers providing some pressure there. Hopkinton, they are so smooth when they're in the offensive zone in front of the net. They just place themselves perfectly. Delaney on the faceoff for Hopkinton. Here come the Bulldogs trying to work their way up ice. Pass over to the near side of Sam Henry. Top of the circle he goes, leaves it behind him for Strawn. We'll get an offside. Face off in the neutral zone. It's Delaney for the Hillers and Tabor Levant for Old Rochester, as that shot is going to be deflected by O'Leary. On the right side, it's Noah Strawn. Around the boards it goes. Coming up on the near side, it's Abbott. Takes it down. Back in Old Rochester territory. Into the right circle, hard hit into the boards by Simos. Coming up the near side, it's Strawn looking for the shot here on the left circle. Was hoping that someone would be there on the right side, but no one is there. Now Pickens picks it up for the Hillers off the Powers attempt. Powers from the blue line with the slapper. And that one is deflected by a couple of players. There's Powers again. Well defended there by Simos. Back to the neutral zone goes Labonte with possession. And here comes Sloan off the steal. The slapper in the slot. And that is going to be glove save by Cunningham. We get a little pushing and shoving after the fact. Cunningham really put under pressure there.
Yeah, that was a huge save for Old Rochester.
Beauty of a drive down ice by Sloan. Labonte and Sloan on the faceoff. 9:51 left to go in the first period. Scoreless game in this quarterfinals playoff matchup in the South Division III bracket. Over to Vokey. And that one is going to be wrapped up by Cunningham. Power shot from Vokey. Another faceoff. Hiller's getting a good amount of shooting opportunities early on as that one goes behind the net, and the net, I think, came out of place there, and also the goaltender lost his stick. They will put
I think that's why the net kick got dislodged, because he lost the stick.
Yep. Face off once again. For the most part, Hiller's in control as that one is going to be wrapped up, and then a push after the fact. That is going to be a penalty right there. It was Volke on another slapper from the blue line, and then Temple took a fall to the ice on a push. I think it was Landon Goguen, the captain, and surprisingly, no penalty. They really are holding the whistles here.
Oh, boy.
Well, hockey's a tough physical sport. Obviously, in the NHL, you can get away with a whole lot more than pushing, but typically in high school, that's not the case, as we'll get an icing here. But they are holding the whistles. They're letting these two teams play, and they are both putting on a show so far this afternoon. Face off in the Bulldogs zone. Bullers have had it there for the most part. Delaney on the faceoff for the Hillers. Over to the far side goes Powers. Around the net, pass to the near side. It's Henry coming up the boards to the neutral zone. Body check there, but Henry's able to get possession for Old Rochester, leaving it out into the circle, turning around, looking for the shot, and that is just wide to the right by Strawn. And then briefly taken by the Hillers, but now contesting is Henry. Over to the far side board, top of the circle, trying to find Henry in the slot. Someone lost their stick, gets the slapper off. Play will continue. It's taken back by Abbott. Here comes Abbott, driving up ice, cutting across to the far side. Around two defenders, trying to backhand it in. Deflected by Cunningham as the Bulldogs work their way back up the near side. Henry over to Strawn, and we'll have a whistle.
I think it looked like a little offsides to me.
Yeah, offside call. We'll have a faceoff in the neutral zone. 8:31 left to go in the first period. Both these teams going back and forth possession-wise, and some impressive shots coming from both sides. No one has yet to really take control of this game. On the near side, Goguen. Poked back into the neutral zone. Coming down is Horgan, looking for the slapper top of the circle, deflected by the defender, Evan Stanley. Caught up along the boards is Horgan. Now Horgan in the left circle, just wide to the left there. Pass once again behind the net. Shifting over is Nick Temple to try to get to it. Over there is Volke, just waiting along that blue line for his chance. Temple's shot from the left circle deflected. Bulldogs having trouble getting it out of their zone when the Hillers put it around the net. And we'll have an icing there. Well, Mike, I'd say Hopkinton, for the most part, in control of this one so far.
Yeah, they seem to have more puck control than Old Rochester. But, you know, that all could change. This game is getting physical. Hopefully, they get to keep their heads cool.
Yeah, and that has been one thing about the Hillers, that in some games, especially close ones, they've lost their cool sometimes, and they can't do that in this one. And so far, they've seemed pretty reserved. As Raphael comes up the ice, and we are going to get a whistle there for the offsides. And I think maybe old Rochester's showing off some emotions a little more than the Hillers so far.
Sure.
Labonte on the faceoff for old Rochester up against Sloan. There's a slapper from the neutral zone as O'Leary will get a stick on that one. Attempted slapper by Labonte. Over to the near side, there's a pair of Labonte brothers, Zachary and Ryan, both very good hockey players. Sloan behind the net. Coming up the near side, shot from the slot, deflected by the defender. It was Sloan getting in front of it. And these Hillers defensemen are hard at work today, and they are doing a nice job deflecting these shots and saving some work for Dylan O'Leary. We'll have a couple changes by both teams. Face off in the Hiller zone. Tabor, Labonte, and Delaney, and that one right off the right post. That was a close one. Still in the Hiller zone. On the slapper was Goguen there. That was, can't get any closer than that without a goal. And we'll have another icing call.
Yeah, from my angle, you know what? There was a lot of room over there, and the goalie's best friend is that post.
Yes, certainly is. Got lucky on that one. Back to the neutral zone. Bulldogs in control. Up the near side goes Goglin. There's a slapper. Glove save by O'Leary on the wrister by Henry. The captain there launching one from the neutral zone. Well, this team certainly a different animal than the Silver Lake team we saw last week in the first round. A lot of good shooters on this old Rochester team, and they get a lot of distance, some of these forwards on their shots. Up the near side boards is Vokey. Top of the circle, wrists that one, and that's wrapped up by Cunningham. Vokey giving the pressure right back to the Bulldogs. Sloan on the faceoff up against LeBlanc. Around the net goes Powers. Up the near side board to Raphael. Over to the blue line. Slap shot there. That was Coveney looking for Temple in the slot. Temple with a laying a hard check into the boards as Sloan tries to poke it out. Bulldogs working their way back up ice. A good steal there from the left circle as Raphael. He's tripped up by the defender. Another good play by Sloan. Raphael trying to steal that one away as he goes at it with Sloan. That's Jack Sloan, and now here comes DJ Sloan up the boards on the right circle, around the net, trying to leave it in the slot. Good pickup by Strawn. He will get it back into the Hiller's zone, and we will have a whistle there for the icing. 6:01 left to go in the first period. We'll have another faceoff in the Bulldog zone. And you see a lot of line changes in this game. These two teams are working hard out there, which means they are going to change up their rotation quite a bit because they are both putting each other to the absolute maximum capacity they can handle. Around the net, Abbott. Chased down along the near side board. Hard check there as Henry taking some contact from Delaney. Picked up on the left side, put across by Simos. Loose puck taken by LeBlanc coming up the near side. Leaving it into the neutral zone as Abbott trips up. Back over to the far side. Tabor Lamonte on the chase down. Hard check into the boards. On the near side, Henry. Back to the blue line, and there's a wrister by Goglin. Just wide to the right there, but O'Leary did get a piece of that with his stick as well. Goglin looking for another one into the slot, and he couldn't find Lamonte there. Good coverage by the Hillers defenseman, both stacking the slot, not letting the Bulldogs have that opportunity. Top of the circle, and that one went off his own man. It was Evan Stanley on the shot. That one went off of Henry. Here comes the Hillers. It's a two-on-one coming up ice, stolen away by Goglin. Goglin puts it down the near side over to Henry. Now back to Goglin, looking across, and there to pick it up, it is the Hillers' Horgan. And that one knocked down by Temple around the near side board, chased down by Goglin. There's Temple. An attempted pass over to the right circle, stolen away by Strawn. And he puts it up and over. A couple of players on both sides. Back into the Hiller's zone. O'Leary will have to wrap that one up. 4:22 left to go in the first period. Scoreless game. Hopkinton against Old Rochester Fairhaven. Quarterfinals of the South Division III playoffs. Both teams scored 9 goals in the first round of the playoffs and had dominant victories. Attempted wrister from the top of the circle. Now the slot, there's a slapper, and that one is going to be wide to the right and wrapped up by O'Leary. It is Ryan Raphael on the one-timer there. O'Leary being put to work in these last couple of series. Going on the faceoff. Up the near side, picked up in the neutral zone by Labonte. Around the boards, there's Vokey. Over the far side of Pickens. Hard check into the corner. Coming around, it's DJ Sloan. Up the near side he goes. And it's Coveney doing battle with Raphael along the near side boards, and Hiller is able to take over, but no one there in the neutral zone to pick it up. The Bulldogs taking it back, 11 offsides there. Both teams going to make some changes. 3:34 left to go in the first period as we have a line change here on both sides and a face-off in the neutral zone. Owen Delaney up against Tabor Levante. Back ice, it's Coveney. Around the net he goes to the far side. Back to the neutral zone, chased down by Goglin. Goglin, backhander, back to Levante. There's Delaney meeting up with Levante. Levante able to get around him over the far side of Strawn. That one picked up and put out of play by Simos. Back to the Hiller zone we go. A lot of stoppages in this first period. A lot of icing and offsides because both of these teams really dueling and just the ultimate goal, keep the puck out of your zone with these two great scoring teams. Chased down back ice by Strawn, up the near side board, picked up in the neutral zone by Coveney. He'll put it up around the far end. There's Stanley and a hard check as Stanley met up with Simos and now on the right circle for Old Rochester as they try to get it back into the Hiller zone. Well played there by Delaney. And that one wrapped up by Cunningham. Close call there on the far away shot. Lindquist and Levante on the faceoff. Behind the net. Up the far side of Pickens. It's taken back by Levante, who's trying to drive up ice. Hard check there by Horgan laying it down. Up the near side, Raphael meeting up with Temple. There's Levante putting it back towards the blue line. And there's Austin, who will put it off of O'Leary. And Rochester having trouble finding a good open shot in the Hiller's defensive zone. Hopkinton defending extremely well so far in this game. Coming up the near side, it's Pickens. Less than 2 minutes left to go in the first period. Hard check of the boards. It's Temple met up with Strawn. And now a battle along the near side. Coming out with it is Jack Sloan. Puts it to the far side of Rolf. Someone lost their stick. It is on the ice over there. On the far side. And on the break, it is Henry. Henry in the slot, wrist it, goal, Old Rochester. First goal of the game comes from the Bulldogs. 1:24 left to go in the first period. Sam Henry with a beauty of a wrister from the slot right in front of the net. Great assists from the left side as well. And you allow shots on net like that, sooner or later, you're gonna give one up.
That's it, they're taking a chance every time the shooter's off as possible.
Ryan Lamont on the faceoff with Owen Delaney. Back to Vokey. Up the near side he goes, and it's picked up back ice by Goglin. Into the corner, turning around. Coming up the middle, here is Raphael looking for the break, top of the circle, wide to the right he goes there. Along the far side is Simos trying to get possession for the Hillers, back ice Vokey. And was that a thrown stick or did he lose it?
I couldn't tell. I'm trying to watch the camera and I saw that in my peripheral.
I saw that from the corner of my eye. It looked like he threw it, but I think it just fell out of his hand. Because the official was right there, there definitely would have been a whistle if that even remotely looked right. Intentional. And that was Will Abbott who lost his stick. Delaney along the far side boards, and you see the scraped up ice over there. They'll have to clean that up after this period. As these two teams have been skating around quite a bit in this first period, back and forth. And Delaney missing an opportunity there. Whiffed at that one, and now Labatt was trying to take it over. There's Labatt, and no one is up ice as Strawn already came back to the neutral zone to avoid the offsides call. Pickens. Put that back briefly into the Bulldog zone. 2 seconds left. That's how the first period's going to end. 1-0 Old Rochester leading the Hopkinton Hillers. And that is certainly not the way the Hillers intended that period to go. But this is a great battle between two very good hockey teams. And there is still a lot of hockey left to be played. This is Hopkinton Hillers boys varsity hockey on HCAM.
Have you ever considered texting and driving? If so, you should know the consequences. If caught texting and driving for the first time, you could get an $100 fine plus your license taken away for 60 days. The consequences only get worse the more you get caught. Even if you don't get caught, there could be serious effects. You could get into a car accident and hurt yourself or someone else. Texting and driving is a very dangerous combination, so stop before this happens to you.
Welcome back to Pirelli Veterans Arena in Franklin, Massachusetts. It is Hopkinton Hillers playoff hockey on HCAM. Tom Nappy on the call, Mike Terosian adding some commentary and running the camera. And we have ourselves a great battle between the fifth-seeded Old Rochester Fairhaven Bulldogs and the fourth-seeded Hopkinton Hillers in the quarterfinals of the South Division III bracket. And as we enter the second period, it is Old Rochester leading 1-0 as they scored a goal with 1:24 left to go in the first period. Sam Henry with a wrister from the slot as the Hillers trying to score one early here. It was Delaney from the left circle. And here comes Old Rochester on a quick break down ice. Let's take it right back over to the far side board. We've got the offside call there as the bot got a stick on it. Some substitutions for the Bulldogs. And both teams have an enormous fan section here this afternoon. Some great fan support. You see the Hillers fans wearing red, white, and blue today. That is their distraction theme, I guess, and I like the red, white, and blue. But well, initially, I thought it was the other team's fans.
As long as it's not orange, I'm happy with it.
Raphael is met up with Sloan on the far side, and here come the Hillers. Well defended there, but Hillers still in Old Rochester territory. The wrister from the right circle, wide to the left by Pickens, over the blue line. That one right off the defender as Volke going for the one-timer there. Went off of Austin and off the goaltender's stick. There goes Pickens behind the net. Chasing it down is Sloan out in front, and it is covered up by Cunningham. Hunter Temple nearly was able to poke that in. Sloan and Temple right in front of the net. That was a brilliant save by Cunningham.
Yeah, I'm surprised that wasn't in. I mean, he was deep inside that net.
Yeah, he went as deep as he possibly could without letting that one pass the line. But Chase Cunningham getting the job done so far for the Bulldogs, even though there has been a whole lot of pressure from this Hillers team. They've gotten a lot of great shots on net, but no goals as of yet. Up the near side is Simos. And here comes the Bulldogs. As they're looking for their opportunity, trying to take control of this game, up 1-0. High slot, there's the slapper there, and a good job by O'Leary getting the left leg down. Up the far side, and the chase down, the slapper. That is off of Cunningham by Abbott. Abbott catching up with it, but tripped up a little bit, and will poke it over to the offensive zone. Bulldogs back into the neutral zone on the far side. Henry, that was up and over a couple Hillers forwards. Nearly getting the ref on that one was Rolf. Along the near side, picked up by Temple. He'll put it around the end board. Temple trying to get to that one at a quick pace. Powers puts it across. Picking it up there is Abate. Back into the Hiller zone it goes, and we will have a whistle there for the offsides. Icing, rather. 12:33 left in this second period. This game has just been constant back and forth momentum shifts. Good stick work on the far side by Powers. Picked up into the neutral zone with a backhander by Delaney, now over to the near side board. It's Labonte getting around Pickens. Here comes Austin. Around the end board in the Hillers territory. Temple on the near side, and he's met up with Strong before we get a whistle. And officials going to get a new puck here as we'll have a face-off in the Hiller zone. Laney for the Hillers. Around the inboard goes Pickens. Hard check there as Abbott met up with Henry. Backhanded around the net by Delaney. Up the near side to Simos. And there's Delaney, top of the right circle. He's met with a check into the backboard. Up the near side, Strawn. Good contact there in the neutral zone by both sides. Taking it out of the Bulldog zone is Strawn. He has a quick break up the near side boards. In the right circle, a slapper deflected by the defender, Pickens. Around the end board goes Sloan. Sloan up the far side of Oki. Here comes Simos. Top of the circle, wristing it in front of him in the slot. Now in the left circle, it's Jack Sloan. Up the near side to DJ Sloan. In the left circle, into the slot, a slapper deflected by the defender. Sacrificing his body was Landon Goguen. Great defensive play there. Back to the blue line, quick break up ice is Ryan Labonte into the left circle. O'Leary comes out of net, pokes it away. No one is goaltending, but it is saved by Temple as he's able to get a stick on it and backhand it out of the way. What a dangerous job by Dylan O'Leary there, coming way out of the net and leaving it wide open with two Bulldogs right in front. But that might have been a game saver there by Hunter Temple. Back into the Hiller's zone, picked up by Jack Sloan as he's met with some hard contact into the boards there by Henry. In the neutral zone, Horgan up the near side, trying to find someone. Powers picks it up for the Bulldogs. There's Boakie, takes it back ice, looking up. That was a great pass off the board to Horgan. And Old Rochester with an opportunity here. He's trying to poke it into the slot. It was Noah Strawn. No one could get there fast enough. Well defended by Coveney. And Hiller's crowding the slot with these defenders because they know that's what the Bulldogs are looking for. Back ice up the boards, Coveney. And that one is going to be out of play and icing. We'll get the switch up with 9:35 left in the second period. And right now, Mike, it's the Bulldogs really putting the pressure on.
Yeah, the Bulldogs seems to have more control right here.
Around the end board, Delaney. At the far side, back into the Hiller zone, picked up by Connor Delaney. Puts it around the near side as Simo's trying to get a break on it. And here's Owen Delaney, left circle, into the corner. Around the end board he goes. It's going to be picked up on the other side. There's a shot right in front of the net. And that was a beauty by Connor Delaney. Nearly had that. And then it was nearly poked in. Then another shot, top of the left circle by Rolf. And that was off the right leg pad of Cunningham. Around the end board goes Owen Delaney. Poked away by Stanley. The Bulldogs get it back. Good pass into the neutral zone, and that is Stanley putting the shot on net. Larry had to briefly glove that one. Strawn, pass over to the far side of Goguen, and now back up the middle. It is taken by Abbott. An opportunity here, backhands it around the end board. And now it is Hunter Temple, who's met with a check on the far side by Goguen. Doing battle right now is DJ Sloan and Noah Strawn. Around the end boards it goes. Picked up by the Bulldogs as Tremblay was there. Pass up to Henry. Now that one off the stick of Strawn, back into the Hillers defensive zone. And there's Strawn at the top of the right circle. He's met with a check by Pickens. At the far side of Sloan. Now over to Hunter Temple. In the left circle, doing battle with Powers. Around the end board goes Powers. On the far side, it is Pickens. Around the net, Temple. Around the net he goes. Pass over to the right point. Pickens looking for the shot there, deflected by a defender. And Sam Henry able to get a stick on that one. And on the changeup, it was Vokey poking it into the Bulldog zone. Near side, Temple. Behind the net is Powers. Turned around by Levante. Back and forth possessions here in the Bulldogs' defensive zone. Back to the neutral zone, Rolfe on the chase down. 7:07 and ticking left to go in the second period, a 1-0 Bulldogs lead. The only goal of the game came with 1:24 left in the first period, a wrister by Sam Henry. And now Old Rochester looking for another one, but no one there for Ryan Raphael, and tripping up is Evan Stanley. Raphael chases it down back ice. Rolfe in the neutral zone, up the near side, and Delaney missed that one as it went behind him, and now a break into the right circle, and the slap shot deflected by Rolfe on the attempt by Levante. Up the far side board, O'Leary gets the stick on it, and here come the Hillers. Up the near side of Simos. Across the blue line on the left side, and that one put around the boards from the corner and wrapped up by Cunningham. Nearly a goal there. Owen Delaney trying to poke it through, and Will Abbott getting a little pep talk from the official after some contact in the back of the net with Sam Henry. And those two have been going at it all game, but those are two physical, great hockey players. Delaney on the faceoff for the Hillers, puts it behind him. Bulldogs looking for a break here. Taylor Labonte around the net, trying to poke it from the corner. Now out in front, a slapper, and that was off of O'Leary out of play. Noah Strawn on the attempt. And we'll have a whistle as the net came dislodged as well. Hillers will change a pair. Will Pickens and Connor Delaney back into the game. 5:53 left to go in the second period. Picked up by Connor Delaney. Up the near side, Owen Delaney. Owen looking for Abbott in the slot. Just missed him. A little bit too much mustard on that one. Up the near side, Strawn in the right circle, leaves it behind him. Now in the slot, can he get a shot off? No, he'll poke it with the back of the stick. It was Henry on the attempt, wrapped up by O'Leary. And these two teams defending very well. And despite the fact that both of them are getting a fair amount of shots off, they are not really getting any clean shots on either side. Face-off with exactly 5:30 left to go in the second period. Into the slot, Hillers need to get it out of there. Neutral zone to Temple, that one is put to the other end for the offside. We'll have a face-off at center ice. Sloan and Strawn. Excuse me, that was Labonte, the captain. There's Ryan Labonte there. top of the left circle, left behind for Levante. Checking the boards, out of play. No, it's up in the air it goes. Looked like it was going to head towards the bench for a second. On the near side, Raphael puts it to the high slot. The wrister, and that one deflected by O'Leary. On the attempt, it was Landon Goguen. Goguen with the backhanded pass over the left circle. The attempted turnaround denied by Levante. And here comes the Hillers. Someone lost their stick. It was Sloan, but he picks it back up, and we'll have a whistle there as Sloan could not get to it fast enough.
I think he's going in for kicking the stick away.
Yep. Landon Goguen is going to be the first penalty of the game. Hillers on the minute and a half power play. This is a huge opportunity here. That is not what you want to do in this game. Too close of a game for that. Too good of a team. Let's see if the Hillers can take advantage. Rolf, top of the circle, and will try to get that one in the five hole, but Cunningham is able to put a stop to it. Little push right down the pike by Rolf, and we'll have a face-off in the left circle. Delaney leaves it behind him. There's Rolf. Around the end board. Minute 17 left on the power play. Foki is from the point there, and touched by a number of defensemen as Powers puts it back into the neutral zone. There's Powers up the near side. Rolf catches up with it back ice. Pass across to Foki. That one up to Abbott. Hillers are going to need to be more aggressive on this power play. This could be the only one you get in this game. And now the Bulldogs looking for a goal here. Still in the slot, the wrister, and that one went off of the glove of O'Leary and then into the ceiling and out of play. That was a beauty there by Henry. The Bulldogs keeping the pressure on even on the power play. That is not a good sign for the Hillers. 37 seconds left to go on the power play. 3:51 left in the second period. Back to the neutral zone, chased down by Powers. Go back ice, trying to burn some time off this power play. There's Powers. Covety, leaving it over for Temple, and here come the Hillers with an opportunity here. To the right side of the circle is Sloan, and around the end boards it goes, cleared away by Powers. Up the near side, picked up by Sloan. Jack Sloan leaving it behind, looking for the shot, turns it around over to the left circle, poked out by DJ Sloan. Back around the end boards it goes by Goguen. Pickens. Into the slot, now back ice to Levante. Power play is over, it is even strength. Levante leaving it into the slot and trying to skate down with it was Goguen. He was denied by the defenseman on the steal. A brilliant steal. And now coming up ice off the steal is Sloan. And Jack Sloan trying to find his brother, DJ Sloan, and was a little wide to the right there. 2:37 and counting left in the second period as around the end board it is Owen Delaney trying to steal it away. Good battle between Owen Delaney and Owen Powers. Up the near side now, it is Noah Strawn into the right circle. Could not get the shot off, puck got loose and rolled towards O'Leary who will wrap it up. And he will have another faceoff in the Hiller zone. Delaney up against Demerinville. Over to the far side is Stanley. Now, a quick break here. Right circle, the wrister, and that is just wide to the left by Abbott. And this is going to be a glove save by O'Leary. Henry on the wrister from the neutral zone. We'll have another face-off in the Hiller zone with 2:04 left to go in the second period. DJ Sloan will be on the faceoff against Tabor Levante. Picked up by Coveney up the far side. And poked back ice to Stanley. Trying to get it back into the Hiller zone in the left circle. Good stick work by Sloan to keep it away from Tabor Levante. But here's the steal. In the left circle, the wrist there. It's wide to the right by Strawn. Went up the near side boards. Levante picked it up. We'll have a whistle. That one is going to be an offside. We'll have a face-off in the neutral zone. 1:35 left to go in the second period. Good defensive battle all period long. Both teams have had some great shots on net, but these defenses and goaltenders are playing some amazing hockey here this afternoon. Back ice picked up by Powers. Hiller's fans getting into it, trying to cheer on their team. Rolf on the chase down. Poked away by Raphael. Hard check into the boards there. And that was Coveney there with a frustration check on Levante. That's some good physical hockey there by Coveney. Up the near side into the corner, Simos puts it around the end board to Abbott. Abbott trying to get it around the net. Looking for someone at the blue line, finds Vokey. Vokey going to take it around. And he is going to try to get it to Rolf, but be tripped up. Back to Vokey, there's offsides. 42.8 seconds left to go in the second period. 1-0, Old Rochester Fairhaven leading the Hillers. Face off, DJ Sloan, Tabor Levant. And the official giving a warning to Noah Strawn. As Strawn and Lindquist, I think, were doing a little bit of trash talking on the face off. As Pickens around the end board. Lindquist, top of the circle. Pass back to Strawn. Strawn puts it around the end, over to Goguen. Goguen wrists it back into the Hiller's zone. We'll have a whistle there. Another icing call. Sloan and Labonte. And there's the one-timer by Jack Sloan, wrapped up by Cunningham. That was a nice shot there by Jack Sloan. The Hillers need to do more of that. Take advantage of the opportunity. Stop trying to pass and just get it to the net.
Put it in front, let somebody pick up the trash.
Exactly. Hard hit behind the net by Simos. Into the slot, a pass across by Sloan. Looking for someone there on the one-timer. And that's going to do it for the second period of play. A back-and-forth defensive battle between Old Rochester Fairhaven and the Hopkinton Hillers. And after two periods of play, it is Old Rochester Fairhaven 1, the Hopkinton Hillers nothing. It is Hillers boys varsity playoff hockey on HCAM. Third period up next.
Do you have what it takes?
Will you make a difference?
Always an adventure.
Police and fire working together.
Utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
Welcome back to the Pirelli Veterans Arena in Franklin. We are ready for the third period. It is a 1-0 Old Rochester lead over the Hillers, a scoreless second period. It is fifth-seeded Old Rochester Fairhaven against fourth-seeded Hopkinton. And this game is a bid to the semifinals of the South Division III bracket, as the Hillers will put it up the far side, working left to right across your screen. Backhanded by Connor Delaney, and now the Bulldogs looking for an opportunity as Levante got it in the slot. Back to the neutral zone it goes. Picked up back ice by Simos. Backhanded into the Old Rochester zone, and here's an attempt break by Noah Strawn. Backhands it, and it is denied by O'Leary. Back up the near sideboard it goes, poked out by Abbott over towards the official. What a jump out of the way there. There's a slapper by Connor Delaney, and that'll go back into the Bulldogs zone while Hopkinton makes a change. Up the near side, Connor Delaney over to Jack Sloan. Sloan leaves it in the slot and denied by Temple, and then a goal by the Hillers. DJ Sloan on the secondary. That was a beauty by DJ Sloan on the one-timer off the deflected Temple shot. And it is a tie game at one apiece. Temple off of Cunningham, and DJ Sloan upper decks it.
Wow.
And just like that, the Hillers right back in this one. J.H. Vokey puts it back into Bulldogs territory. Well, we have ourselves a new game. Over the blue line, and there's a wrister by Pickens, getting some air under that one, but Cunningham wraps it up. Face off again in the Bulldogs zone as the Hillers putting on the pressure. DJ Sloan up against Strawn. To the blue line of Coveney on the ground. He keeps it in, then DJ Sloan will put it in on the left corner with the backhander. What a beauty by Sloan. Coveney with the initial shot from the blue line. DJ Sloan sneaks to the left corner and just knocks it in to make it a 2-1 game in favor of the Hillers. What a change of events here.
I don't know what was in that talk that the coach gave in between the periods, but I say it's working.
Give the puck to DJ Sloan. Over the left circle, chased around by Coveney. That one poked out by Abbott. Back ice it goes, and we'll have a whistle. Face-off coming in the Hillers zone as the Bulldogs trying to get back into this one. Xavier Levante on the face-off against Owen Delaney. Over to the neutral zone. Picked up by Goglin, and now here's another shot from the high slot by Simos. Turned around by Abbott over to the far side. That one poked through into the neutral zone. Up to the corner. And put back into the Bulldogs' defensive zone. Hillers with some early pressure and two early goals in this third period. Here's Tabor Levante leaving it behind, and that one put out of play by Henry. He's trying to upper deck that one, but upper decked it a little bit too much. We'll have a line change. Top of the circle. Shot into the right circle, deflected by Sloan. Here come the Hillers. Breaking into Bulldogs territory was Jack Sloan. To the top of the right circle, a shot, and it's a glove save. Pickens went glove side on that one, and Cunningham gloves it up for the faceoff in the Bulldog zone. DJ Sloan making things happen for the Hillers in this third period. Two beautiful goals, and now in front of the net, that one nearly backhanded in by Jack Sloan. Bulldogs trying to clear it away, having major trouble to start off this third period. On the right circle now, the wrister put across by Pickens. That's picked up by Jack Sloan out in front of the net. Nearly a goal there, but it was deflected by the defenseman, then Cunningham on the Lindquist attempt. Up the far side boards it goes. Line change by the Bulldogs. And you wonder if the Bulldogs may be getting a little tired here. They've had to defend all game, and this has just been a game that's been really all about conditioning. Fast-moving hockey here, and lots of back-and-forth momentum shifts. Chased down in the back of the net by Vokey, now picked up by Coveney. Slammed into the boards on the near side. And here comes the Bulldogs back into their defensive zone. Strawn up the near side board, and now cuts across the middle. High slot, trying to get around the defender, but can't. Delaney takes it away. 11 minutes and ticking left to go, and now Hopkinton is in control of this one with two early goals by DJ Sloan. Up the far side, here comes Labonte, and he is turned away in the slot by Vokey. Back ice now, Noah Strawn, pass across over to number nine, Evan Stanley, one of the captains for the Bulldogs. There's Goguen. And he will meet up with Hunter Temple along the near side board, and they continue to do battle. Puck ends up in the Hillers' defensive zone on the stick of Coveney. We'll put it back down into the Bulldogs' territory, and we will have an icing there. Well, the Bulldogs certainly going to need to put the pressure on now. Hillers up 2-1. First goal of the game was scored with 1:24 left in the first period by Sam Henry, but the Hillers have responded. Certainly better late than never. Powers pass across to Devonte. Here comes Zach Horgan, or excuse me, DJ Sloan. Good stick work there by Sloan, looking for another one, maybe a hat trick, and he's turned away in the slot as Powers able to knock that one away. There's a shot from the high slot. Wide to the left goes Pickens. Up the far side board, picked up by Sloan. Back to Pickens and turned away there as it'll go off the stick by O'Leary. There's Labonte on the shot. And that one going to be turned away by Cunningham. Up the ice is Henry. Pick up by Simos up the far side board. He's met with Henry. And tangled up there is Owen Delaney and Owen Powers. Trying to get that puck out of the corner. Just stuck in there and finally comes out. Here comes Labonte. Stolen back away by Simos, and he will put it over towards Cunningham, who's going to be forced to wrap that one up. Well, Cunningham has goaltended very well for the Bulldogs, but he kind of let his guard down early on in this third period, and if you let your guard down against the Hillers, they'll be pretty quick to take advantage of that.
Yeah, mentally it's going to be a hot day to come back, those two fast goals after two beautiful periods of being between the pipes.
Here comes Raphael up the near side. He's turned away as it was 1-on-3. Good coverage by the Hillers. And Hopkinton really now playing prevent here. He's trying to keep the puck out of their zone, and they are doing a good job at it in this third period. 8:35 left to go. Over to the blue line. The wrister. That's off of Cunningham. Into the slot it goes. It was Vokey on a beauty of a power shot there. Vokey now with possession once again. Puts it back into the Bulldogs territory. Cunningham will have to put that one off his stick. Up the near side of Goguen. He's turned away, stolen by DJ Sloan, looking for someone out in front. Puts it towards Temple. Oh. Temple trying to poke it in. Cunningham forced to wrap it up. And now DJ Sloan and Noah Strawn, a little bit of pushing there. Ryan Labonte, excuse me. 8:12 left in the period. Hiller's in full control so far in this period. As they are trying to hold on and advance to the next round to head over to Gallo Arena in Bourne Wednesday night. Out in front, trying to poke it through. A number of players in front of the net will have a whistle to stop the action. It was Will Abbott trying to poke it through, and there was about four Bulldogs in front of him. It is no goal as Cunningham had it wrapped up, and then the net came out of place for the stoppage. It is a faceoff in the Bulldog zone. 8:02 left in regulation. Far side, coming across, Levante gives it to the slot. Now in the neutral zone, it's Strawn. Up the far side board. Picked up by Rolf. There's Delaney back to the near side. Levante in the high slot, pushed out of the way by Simos. Good defensive play there, as Noah Strawn was looking for the shot. We'll have a whistle for the icing there. Line change for both teams. Face off in the Hiller zone. Bulldogs trying to provide some pressure. Ryan Labonte up against DJ Sloan on the face off. Top of the right circle, the wrister turned away by O'Leary. The attempt by Landon Goguen. Behind the net it goes, picked up by Vokey. Turns it away to Lindquist on the far side board.
Oh.
Back to the Bulldogs territory it goes. That's going to be icing. Face off in Hiller's territory. Owen Delaney up against Tabor Levante. Switch it up on the Bulldog side. Have Noah Strawn on the faceoff. Strawn puts it top of the circle. Wrister turned away by O'Leary on the Goguen attempt. Hard hit into the boards by Vokey. Here's a break by the Hillers. The shot, it is going to be off the left leg pad of Cunningham. The attempt was by Abbott. Could not get the angle he wanted on that one. And now here come the Bulldogs back into Hiller's territory as they're getting a little bit desperate. Henry has that one turned away by O'Leary. And now another one from the top of the circle, and that's put in! Sam Henry puts it in off the Landon Goguen attempt. And that's the second goal for Henry with 6:33 left to go in the period. We have ourselves a hockey game here in Franklin.
All new ball game. All new ball game.
Two to two. DJ Sloan has both goals for the Hillers. He's in the faceoff. Jack Sloan up the far side board. What a game these two teams are playing here this evening. And that one nearly put in. Cunningham barely was able to wrap that up between his legs. It was a wrister by Connor Delaney. That was a beauty. And that was very close to crossing the line.
They keep up the shooter, they should have another goal anytime now.
Rolf up the far side. Lindquist picked up by Powers. up the boards to Austin. Here come the Bulldogs. High slot. And that is going to be a glove save by O'Leary. Duarte on that shot. Bulldogs providing the pressure. Tabor Labonte, Delaney on the faceoff. Around the end board it goes, picked up by Abbott. He's met with a hard check into the boards by Henry. Here is Henry, who's going to leave it behind for Labonte. Back to the blue line, the wrister. That one is turned away to the left side. There's Henry leaving it out in front, picked up by Stanley. Now it is Goguen, top of the left circle. That was put in front, nearly put in. And then the net came dislodged as Strawn came crashing into the goaltender, O'Leary. And I'll tell you what, that was an unnecessary hit by Strawn. And that is very close to a penalty if they don't call it.
Yep. Yeah, some good sportsmanship right there. Give him a tap, you know, you okay? Hey, it's all good, see? That's how you play hockey at the high school level.
Yeah, these two teams certainly are class acts today. There has not been really any dirty play at all in this game. Top of the circle, turned away into the slot, picked up by Coveney. Now it's Delaney. Someone lost a glove there. Back ice it goes. 5:22 and counting left in regulation. It is a 2-2 game. Hillers tied it up with 14:03 left in the third period, less than a minute in. And then less than 20 seconds later, Sloan put in another one. And then with 6:33 left, Henry put in his second goal for the Bulldogs to make it a even game. And I could not predict how this one is going to end. This has been a great battle here today. DJ Sloan over to Vokey. He will try to knock that one in from the high slot. It's turned away by Cunningham, and now behind the net it goes. Picked up by DJ Sloan, over to the blue line. The wrister is wide to the left by Pickens. Picked up on the far side by Rolf. He'll pull it around the end boards. Pickens going to race to it, but getting it away is Raphael. Rolf gets it on the far side, takes it over around the boards for the Hillers. Now into Bulldogs territory, top of the circle, wrists it, and that is going to be gloved by Cunningham. Behind the net, Simos met up with a Bulldog. It was a hard hit there. No penalty, however. It was Simos against Labonte. And if this was a regular season game, there'd be a couple more penalties on both sides.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
These officials really holding their whistles for this one. There's been one penalty in the game, and it was against the Bulldogs, and that came in the second period.
Oh, nice tap.
The left circle, the slapper, yes! Will Abbott powers it through. Wide open opportunity. Got the perfect shot and was able to put it in glove side.
Nice little give with the skate. Bolt picked it up.
That was an absolute beauty.
3-2
Hillers. DJ Sloan and Noah Strawn on the faceoff. Back ice it goes. All three goals for the Hillers in this period. Maybe a fourth here. An attempted pass over the right circle to Temple. He's met with a hard check into the boards. 3:38 in counting. Bulldogs need to make something happen here. Up the slot it goes, and that'll be wrapped up by O'Leary. Face off will be in the left circle. Over the Center point of the shot, and that's turned away on the Goguen attempt. To the near side, chased down by Levante. Back ice he goes, leaves it behind for Goguen. Goguen get that one with his skate to Henry. And the Bulldogs just trying to figure out how to keep this puck in the Hiller's zone. Here's Henry over to the slot. A turnaround and denied in front. There's Labonte on the shot attempt. Good pickup by the Hiller's defenseman. Yeah. Back behind the net. Caught up with by Goguen. Out in front, and that's put in! Sam Henry with the hat trick. Wow. Unbelievable. Right through the five hole goes Henry. Henry and Goguen combining on that effort once again. Well, this game started off all defense, and now it's all offense. We have ourselves a shootout here at Veterans Pirelli Arena. EJ Sloan around the near side. Jack Sloan, Lindquist. Backhanded into the slot, picked up by Austin. Back to the neutral zone we go. This is one of those games when you say it is a shame one of these teams have to lose here this afternoon.
That's right.
Behind the net is Vokey. And that is back into Bulldogs territory. We'll have a whistle for the icing. 2:07 left to go in this third period. A 3-3 hockey game. Two Hiller's goals early on. And then Henry with a goal with 6:33. Will Abbott with 3:57. And then at 2:45, Henry with a hat trick. Out to the slot. There's Henry putting that one off the board. Picked up by Delaney. Delaney gets that one into the neutral zone, and it is going to be picked up in the defensive zone for the Bulldogs by Goguen. Over the far side, Delaney around the net. It's Powers. 1:29 left in regulation. Overtime certainly a possibility. Here is Henry. And he was trying to go between the legs there on Connor Delaney. And he did, but could not get to it as Delaney wasn't fooled by that attempted trickery. O'Leary had to wrap it up, however. We are going to have a timeout call. And with 1:19 left, these two teams going to do some talking.
Yeah, they got a lot of talking to do.
It's going to be the Bulldogs who have the puck in the Hiller's zone. But, Mike, what a turn of events in this third period.
Like you said, the offense has showed itself this period. It was all defense, all goalies, and now it's just all offense. You don't know what's going to happen next. Could go anyway.
Six goals in the game, five of them have come in this third period. It is a 3-3 game, 1:19 left. DJ Sloan made it 1-1 with 14:03 left. And then another DJ Sloan goal with 13:47 left shortly after. A beauty of assist by Coveney as well, 6:33. Henry scores for his second time for the Bulldogs. 3:57, Will Abbott, 2:45 left. Sam Henry with the hat trick. And of course, we'll confirm those with the scorebook after the game. Sloan to Jack Sloan, over the far side. Simos. Icing. Back to the Hiller's zone we go. Well, this is where the Bulldogs are going to put all kinds of pressure on. I'm sure they would love to sneak in a goal here and try to avoid overtime. Delaney and Labonte on the faceoff. Delaney switches it up with Simos. Puck logged into the right circle. Simos picks it up. Pass crossed over to Abbott. Maybe the Ehlers on a break here. Top of the circle. That was poked out by Labonte. Over to the blue line. Shot from the right point. Oh, the secondary shot from the slot is covered up by Cunningham. Will Abbott trying to sneak it in from the left side. Net came out of place. It is a faceoff in the Bulldog zone. 52.2 seconds left in regulation. Around the end board, Abbott trying to sneak it in on the left corner. Cunningham is going to wrap that one up and be pushed back. That'll push the net out of place. We'll have another faceoff, this time with 45.8 seconds left. This is what playoff hockey is all about. Unbelievable. I don't even know what to say anymore. Delaney and Labonte on the faceoff. Just back to the blue line, put around by Pickens. Here's a shot to the left side, and it is covered up by Cunningham. What a beauty of a shot that was.
Nice and hot.
From the right side of the blue line by Abbott. seconds left. Back to the top of the circle. The wrists are wide to the left. Goes Coveney. Picked up on the far side by Pickens. Here come the Bulldogs charging into the neutral zone. Top of the circle. The wrister. Off of O'Leary. Into the air it goes. Off the Powers attempt. Top of the left circle is the dangerous Landon Goguen. He's double checked into the boards by Coveney and Delaney. And around the corner, Labonte trying to catch up with it. Into the right circle, turned away by Abbott. Back into the Bulldog zone it goes. Now a matchup in the Bulldog zone as Simos and Powers will both fall and go into the boards. And guess what? That's going to do it for the third period. We are tied at three, and we are going to overtime. What a third period that was. And looking at both benches, these players all look absolutely gassed.
Yeah, they've been out there a long time. Pushing hard, you get tired real quick.
Oh, absolutely. Which team can last longer? That's going to be key in this overtime period. And the officials talking to both teams and I think really giving him a warning. There was some physical play in the third period. Some close calls as far as penalties, but they are holding their whistle. They want these two teams to be able to go out there and play. And they really do not want this game decided because of the officiating. Just to recap, the only goal of the game leading into the third period was scored with 1:24 left in the first period by Sam Henry. Then in the third period, DJ Sloan was able to sneak it in with 14:03 left on a power shot that he just rattled right by Cunningham. And then less than 20 seconds later, 13:47 left, Sloan strikes again with the help of Coveney. That made it 2-1 Ehlers. Then 6:33 left, you get Sam Henry knocking it in, tying it up at two, assisted by Landon Goguen. Then 3:57 left, Will Abbott puts the Ehlers back up, 3-2. And then with 2:45 left, Sam Henry ties it up as he scores his third goal It makes it 3-3, and we are now in a 6-minute overtime period. It is a sudden death overtime. Around the end boards, it's 20 matching up with 20. Over to the high slot, to the right circle, turned away. There's Henry, back ice Rolf. Over to the far side to Connor Delaney. And I expected a close game with these two teams, but not this close, and that was gloved by Simos, but we get the offsides call.
I don't think that was the kind of goal they were looking for.
Nope. Face off in the Hiller zone. 5:32 left of overtime period number one. Well, I think this one will go into the HCAM Classic vault.
I think so too.
To the blue line. Wrister by Goguen, turned away in the slot. Strawn in control, leaving it out in front. And here comes Lindquist for the Hillers, or excuse me, Sloan for the Hillers. Some good stick work there. To the near side, around the boards. Picked up by DJ Sloan. Falling for it on the left circle. DJ Sloan turns it around, trying to sneak it in. Cunningham wraps it up. Rolf calling for it. That was definitely some trickery by the Hillers. Yeah, Rolf calling for it, trying to shift the defense in that direction. DJ Sloan just turns around and tries to sneak it in. But Cunningham just able to pick that one up. Face off in the left circle, Delaney and Levante. Near side of Oki. Around the end board, the Hillers putting the pressure on. That's back to Pickens. And now Oki with the slapper, wide to the left, it's around Cunningham, he gloves it up. Volke nearly wrung that one around Cunningham. Somehow he was able to glove that one. Unbelievable. I don't think Cunningham knows what to say right now. I think he's in shock he was able to get to that one. Volke to the top of the right circle, the Wrister. Turned away on the Pickens attempt. Back to Pickens. Hillers dominating this overtime period so far. We're going to have an offsides. Pickens just behind the blue line on that last pass. Hillers keeping the pressure on. 4:39 left in overtime period number one. Rolf. Up to the other side, hard smash into the boards by Henry. Picked up by Goguen. Rolf trying to launch that one. Here come the Bulldogs. Goguen, top of the right circle. And he will try to wrist that one in, and O'Leary's going to wrap that one up. Trying to sneak that through the five hole. Face off in the Hiller zone. Levante and Simos. Melanette, Coveney. Turned away by Sloan. There's Rolf. It's back into the neutral zone. Back and forth possession changes now. Breaking free, DJ Sloan in the right circle, over to the slot, trying to poke it through. Cunningham's going to have to glove it up. Sloan looking for Simos. Simos trying to sneak that one in, could not get his stick on it. And Cunningham forced to wrap it up. Face off in the Bulldog zone. Delaney and Levante. Back to the center circle to Connor Delaney around the end board. Taken by Henry up the far side. Goguen, top of the left circle, Levante. Leaving it In the left circle, into the slot. Gogolin looking for the shot there. Great defensive play by Abbott. Strawn on the far side. Puts it to the left circle, looking for the backhander. It's taken back by Delaney. Delaney, high slot, wrists it, deflected by the defender, Strawn. Now from the right side, that's put across by Abbott. Abbott, top of the circle, gets it over to the far side. Shot from top of the circle by Delaney is denied by Henry. Around the net it goes, back to the near side, Pickens with the wrister, wide to the right. Now to the blue line, the slapper there, taken by the defenseman, Levante. And up front he goes, that's going to be icing. 2:34 left to go in overtime period number one, 3-3. Back and forth panic attacks by both these teams.
I tell you, I can't contain myself here.
It's unbelievable, this game. Steve Simos, Ryan Levante on the faceoff. Into the slot, taken by Powers. Up the near side, he goes with it to Levante. Good battle in the neutral zone. And we will get the offsides. Faceoff in the Bulldogs' defensive zone. On the icing pole. Simos, Levante. Around the net. Killers have certainly had more opportunities in this overtime period than the Bulldogs. And there was a couple of really close calls and miracle saves by Cunningham. Up the near side is Powers, top of the right circle. Around the net. Over to the blue line, shot from the point by Strawn is wide to the right. Sent back to the neutral zone, Strawn picks it up. High slot turned away by Sloan. It's Jack Sloan, Levante. Left of the circle now, the Hillers taking it back. Cutting across, Rolf. He'll ring it around the end boards. Picked up by Strawn. 1:25 and counting, left in overtime period number one. Gogolin down the far side, and he has an opportunity here from the high slot, turned away by the defender, Pickens. Left side, Levante. High slot here. Gogolin gets around one, and now stolen away by Volke. Taken back by Henry. Accepted pass to Henry. Got away from him, but he's able to gather it back up to Gogolin, top of the left circle. Henry, 50 seconds and counting left to go in overtime period number one, on the right circle. Pass behind net, now the high slot. Able to get away from one, wrists it, and it is wide to the left. Picked up by Strawn. It's Gogolin on that shot, Gogolin on another, that one's wrapped up by O'Leary. Here come the Bulldogs putting some pressure on. .7 seconds left in overtime period number one. Levante to the blue line, looking for the slapper there, missed it. Zachary Levante on the attempt. Hard check into the far side boards. Picked up behind the net by Powers. Over to the near side, coming down to Zachary Levante. Turned away, stolen away by Simos. Simos over the right circle, the wrist there, and it's wide to the left by Abbott, and out of play.
Offside, yeah.
Nearly a goal there, a beautiful setup by Simos. 11.9 seconds left in overtime period number one. We'll go to an overtime period number two after this, and then it's shootout time. That's, of course, unless someone scores. And that is going to be a glove save by O'Leary as Strawn tries it on the one-timer. Face-off in the left circle. 4.3 seconds left. This is one of those games I don't mind if it keeps going. It has been unbelievable. Great performance by both of these teams. Top of the circle, that's it. 3-3 after overtime period number one. We will have overtime period number two coming up next. But we are tied up at three apiece. And this has been some kind of game. We'll take a quick timeout on HCAM. We are just about ready for the second overtime period. A 3-3 game. 6 minutes has been put on the clock. It is overtime period number two. What a game these two teams have played here today. DJ Sloan and Noah Strawn on the faceoff attempt. It's 3-on-3 for this overtime period. So we should note that. Overtime period number two, 3-on-3. That was a new rule implemented by the NHL as well. As the wrister by Strawn, wide to the left. And the next stage would be a shootout. Shall overtime continue? It is sudden death. On the right circle, some good stick work. Trying to sneak it in the right corner, and he does! A goal by Henry, assist by Strawn. And that's going to do it, Old Fairhaven. Old Rochester Fairhaven is going to take the 4-3 victory in overtime period number two. That was Henry on his fourth goal. So I think you know who we have to give the player of the game to. But what a season by the Hillers. It is an absolute shame that it has to end like this. Yeah, this was a game that none of these teams deserve to lose, Mike.
Yeah, I mean, the Hillers mounted that huge comeback, being down by one, coming out with two goals right at the beginning of the third period. And, they're powerful. I mean, they were so evenly matched. And like you said, somebody had to win. It just didn't go our way this time.
Yep, a very even matchup. And this game, on many occasions, could have went either way. What a battle between these two teams. Congratulations to Old Rochester Fairhaven on advancing after an absolutely gutty performance, taking down the Hillers in a road game, going to overtime, and not letting Hopkinton run away with it in the third period after they scored a couple of quick goals. That was a pretty gutty performance there by Old Rochester. And that's why they are in the postseason. And as good as they are, because they do not let the moment get the best of them, and they didn't do that here this evening. And they ended up with the victory. And as you're seeing the two teams shake hands, complete respect by both sides. But Old Rochester Fairhaven pulls off the double overtime 4-3 victory, and that is going to do it for a heck of a season by the Hopkinton Hillers. And I'll tell you what, if you're the Hillers, you have no reason to hang your head. Obviously this one hurts, but what a tremendous year this Hillers team had, Mike.
Sure has. They're a lot of fun to watch. You know, after last year's run that they had, you never expected them to be as strong as they were. Yeah, they pulled it off. They were stronger than ever.
They certainly were. Well, that'll do it for coverage here from Veterans Pirelli Arena, or Pirelli Veterans Arena, excuse me, here in Franklin. I can't even think right now after trying to announce that game. Old Rochester gets the 4-3 double overtime victory over the Hillers. Congratulations to Old Rochester on advancing. Congratulations to the Hillers on a great season. For Mike Tarosian on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Hiller's Hockey on HCAM.